Hey, what is going on, everybody? This is Mr. KB. It is May 10th, 2015, and we're about 3 months removed from the release of The Order 1886, but I just now completed it. The game was developed by Ready at Dawn. They are better known for their PSP iterations of the God of War franchise, which were Ghost of Sparta and Chains of Olympus. I hope I got those titles right. But anyways, those are like two of my favorite God of War titles ever made. Ready at Dawn, I believe this is their first take on a big console game. I held off playing this game for 3 months just because the media and also what you hear on social media from other players of the game was not what was expected, blah 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 blah. And believe it or not, let me see where we are here. I'm gonna start here just because this is part of the revealed already, and I don't actually want to give away anything that hasn't already been revealed. You've probably seen some chapters in between, but honestly, reading those is not gonna tell you anything. To start off, the game is gorgeous. The game is not the best looking game that you will see. There are some technical limitations that I think, like the hair is not as good as I think it should be. It kind of just kind of has one strand here and there that's actually that flows with nature and stuff like that. But the player models, the eyes, the storytelling in this game reaches that uncanny valley that I've seen in very few games. I think maybe Infamous Second Son is the only other game that I've seen that has that eye emotion right in a video game. I could be wrong in assuming that, but that's what I've seen. The game has to be, I believe, looked upon not as an interactive movie if you're gonna put it to match with other medias, but kind of an interactive book. It has chapters, as you guys saw from the beginning. It has a lot of good chapters. Yes, there are some storytelling chapters and they kind of transcend. But if you look at it as an interactive book, the game takes you places. The storytelling is very well paced. The action is very well paced. Yes, it's linear, but it's a video game. What video game isn't linear that isn't a sandbox game? I mean, outside of like GTA, even that to a degree is somewhat linear. You have side missions, you have a beginning, you have an end to the story. Yes, there are side missions you can do which you don't see in The Order or any of that type, but the game is amazing. I went with it with the lowest expectations, and after like an hour, because you essentially have to play through the tutorial state, the phases of the game twice, and I thought, oh, this game's gonna be terrible. And I even told one of my coworkers, like, oh, I really wanted to like the game, but after an hour, I'm kind of quitting, and I'm just gonna finish it. I'm glad I finished it. Cinematics, I've already mentioned, graphics are fantastic. Gunplay in this game is fantastic. There are a lot of guns in this game, and all of them feel different. They all have their weaknesses and their strengths. And if you like to snipe, there's guns for that. If you like to just sidearm, there's guns for that. If you like the special armories that really don't exist in any other game, really didn't even exist in this world, if you want to take it to a realistic state, I suppose I'll have to go dress shopping. Those exist as well. Rules of engagement, monsieur. Do what you must. And they all feel very nice. They all feel very, how can I say, individual from each other. No two guns feel the same in this game, and it's great. I think if this game had a multiplayer aspect that could have been tuned properly, I think the potential for the gunplay that was in here to be a great feeling multiplayer game, man, it, I mean, it's not a missed opportunity because we were never promised one. But if Ready at Dawn was willing to work on maybe multiplayer for part two, if I believe there's going to be a part two, it could be a very big success. It can be very big if tuned correctly, which is what it really comes down to. I'm not going to go into the game all that much. I'm not going to go into the gameplay. You're gonna see a couple things here and there. One of the things that I do think are a downfall to this game is that it, at many times in the course of this game, it feels like it's very QTE heavy. For anybody who does not know what QTE is, those are quick time events. Basically, you get a prompt on the screen to dodge or attack or do certain objectives in the game, and they're not terrible, but sometimes they just might be a little bit too much. And but it doesn't hinder the gameplay outside of perhaps maybe the beginning aspects of it. Played it. I don't know what people were talking about on the internet, talking about 4 to 6 hours. Maybe if you play it on normal, it's 4 to 6, because you'd be able to run through it. Even on the hardest settings, it's not overly difficult. But I did spend about 11 to 12 hours. If you want to cut out the 2 or 3 sections that gave me a tough time, I'm going to say that you could probably finish in maybe 8 to 10 if you were so inclined and you were just uber awesome. The game is long enough. And that's really all I have to say. I mean, I think it's a very good game. You know me, I don't like to show off a lot of the games. I don't like to be like, you gotta play. I don't like to give you guys any of the stories. I don't like to spoil any of that for you. I believe one amongst themselves has to kind of find out if you want to see playthroughs. Obviously, there's playthroughs everywhere on YouTube, everywhere on the internet. You can find people that do that. I don't do that. I highly recommend this game. I do think that the game has great production value, great storytelling. I believe the game at this point is very underrated and has maybe the reviews are a byproduct of the hype that follows the media. People are expecting uber awesome great things, and this game is not going to give you, I guess, the new hotness. But what it gives you is solid production value, solid animation, solid everything. Like, everything about this game, even the ending, when I got to it, I was like, oh, I'm so glad I finished the game. And with this right here, boom, I'm going to end it. I'm going to say play. It's a must play. If you want to buy it, buy it. I'm not going to tell you what to spend, what to do with your money. If you get it on sale, support Ready at Dawn. They're a great developer. This game just kind of, I think, pushes them to another level where I think they will be a powerhouse in the console development for years to come. And that's the way I truly feel. Other than that, highly recommend it. I say must play if you have the time or some money. So yeah, this has been Mr. KB. That has been my review for The Order 1986. And I'll see you guys next time.